Hi, I'm Dr. Satish Kumar and this is Kaizen Dental. Our aim here is to help dentists succeed. A few months ago, we had posted a video about how to practice in Germany after BDS. In that, we had explained the entire process from learning the language to the FSP exam to the KP exam. After looking at that video, a lot of you wanted to know more about the journey. So with us, today we have Dr. Shruti Kasturi. She'll be talking to us about her journey of practicing in Germany after BDS. Dr. Shruti graduated in 2016. Then she learned A1 to C1 German. She cleared her FSP and KP examinations, is practicing dentistry in Germany since 2019. Hi, Dr. Shruti. Thank you for taking out your time and coming to speak to our viewers about how your journey has been to start practicing dentistry in Germany. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Satish, for giving me this wonderful opportunity.
My first question to you is, the most important thing of practicing in Germany is to learn their language, German. How was your experience learning it?
Learning experience is just like any other language. When you learn a new language, it's going to be tough. German is also tough. Again, it's not going to be really tough. When you have this perseverance, no? You sit, learn something new. And one important thing I have to say here is, when I started learning the language, it was just after my graduation. Just after I completed my BDS, I was after 8 months, I reached Germany. And in a span of 2-3 months, I started the course. So I didn't have a lot of gap between my BDS and my German courses. So it was like all in a go. I did it.
So you have to be willing to study. Just put your head down and study.
Yeah, it's not only study. You'll have to practice. You'll have to rehearse. I would suggest, if someone really is in Germany, it is going to be a very big advantage, because when you start learning a new language and when you are in the same place, you hear
you can keep applying it
in the language. Yeah, at least even though when you're not able to reply back to them, you'll understand, okay, this is what they're trying to convey.
So
that helped me a lot. And when you're if at all you're in India and you're just preparing for German or language exams, then I would say concentrate on apps like Duolingo. There's some app called Duolingo. There's a lot of apps like Learn German for free and something like that. And there's also a lot of YouTube channels which actually give this learning German for free, the basic levels like A1 and A2. Okay. I think constant practice, keeping in touch, few movies here and there.
You saw movies?
My German teacher, when I started A1, she was actually telling me to watch this Kinder stories, no? These children storybooks, what you call Audible or something like that.
Yes.
I used to listen a lot, but again, I didn't understand, to be very okay. honest. I never understood, but it was like, okay, I am doing something what my teacher told. I'm just like that.
Understood. So once you do your German, once you learn the language, before you give your first exam, that's the FSP exam, you need to have a job application. So how easy or tough is it to get one?
So first, I'll have to make certain things clear here. It is not that you need a job application for sure in every state. As you already know, like there are 16 states in Germany. Yes. And one bad thing I should say is, not all states are the same. It is like exactly like applying for the dental council in a particular state. You have to have an extra document, say like job application, and in other state you don't need to have that. You'll need this Roentgen pass, or what do you call it? This X-ray pass. There are a few states which ask for X-ray pass and a few states which ask for a job application, so that you don't migrate to another state once you graduate from that state or you approbate from that state.
Okay, so basically they are putting in the effort, so they don't want you to leave the state, basically.
Yeah, basically. But it is not like you shouldn't leave. They
understood. They would prefer
people to leave. They don't prefer you leaving, because there's some kind of bureaucracy also behind this. They don't actually give a lot of applications. No, they don't accept a lot of applicants every year. There is some selected number.
Understood.
I'm not sure about the number, but again, there's no mentioning of the numbers anywhere in the websites or something like that. But at least to what I know from the doctors whom I've already spoken to, it is like you are even though there are a lot of students who actually send out their application forms, they first prefer only a set number of applications for a particular year. So if at all I wanted to practice in Berlin and I've given my application in Baden-Württemberg, they wouldn't actually want me going to Berlin immediately after I finished from Baden-Württemberg. So this is one thing very important. And this is why they ask for the job application, to make sure that you already have a job in the state and you're going to remain in the state at least for the next few years.
Understood. So how was your FSP exam? Was it very tough? How is it? Is it only about German? Is it includes dentistry or how is it?
Okay. So as you know, it is actually basically two exams that you are going to give in Germany to have your license. And the second exam is called as Approbation or the Kenntnisprüfung, KP. And the first is called as the FSP, Fachsprachprüfung is what it is called as. So I'll just elaborate on what is FSP first of all. FSP is nothing but they're just going to test your German language in dentistry. This in the process of getting your approbation, the first step is going to be learning your language from A1 to B2. This A1 to B2 is going to be a normal German. Anybody from any field is going to learn the same. There's not going to be any difference between a dentist or a doctor or an engineer or something like that. Everybody learns the same language till B2. But when you enter C1, there's something called the literature level. Okay, C1 is something a higher level. There's normal C1, which anybody again can do it. But what is actually recommended for dentists like us is the Fachsprache or subject-specific language. Fach is nothing but the subject-specific thing. And Sprache is nothing but the language. So the language which is specific to dentistry is what you learn. And that is the exam you give at the first level. That is called the FSP. So this FSP exam is already almost 90% is concentrated on how good you're able to handle the patient, how good and how better you are able to communicate in a situation in a dental practice in Germany. See, for example, two doctors who are actually dentists who are working there, or they are the member of the dental council, they come and examine you, and the basic questions what they put forth is concentrated on how good you're able to hear. Okay. See, because when you actually learn a language, you will not be able to read all the nuances. Say, for example, we speak Tamil at home, and the Tamil, what we speak in Tamil Nadu is not the same all over, right? You have this
local accent.
Local accent, yeah. So that is very important. And what they expect you is, I'm sorry, I'm a foreigner, I'm an expat, I've come all the way here and learn German, I'm just going to be a dentist now. Can you please to repeat this again so that I hear it properly and examine you properly, is what they expect.
Understood.
So they trick us with all these German words which we actually don't know. But there is no marks that has been awarded when you are able to answer all the questions. It's all about how good you handle the situation, even if you don't understand what they're trying to say.
So now there are 16 states in Germany. So you told me about some require job application, others don't. Is there any other such differences between those states?
Yes, I told few states ask for this Röntgen pass. Your Röntgen is nothing but the X-rays. They call it Röntgen in German. So it's some ask for this Röntgen pass, and some ask for actually this is not job application. The term exact thing is Glaubhaftmachung, which means hopefully you're going to stay in the same state. That is what they ask. That is the exact meaning. Glaubhaftmachung means we need something. This is totally a German thing, okay? They have words like this, which means that supposedly you shouldn't travel to any other state after you complete your approbation in the particular state, is what is Glaubhaftmachung. So for this, you can either submit a job application, or you can even tell, because I didn't know this. When I did it, I was searching for job like, my God, I searched for days, not for a lot of months or something like that. It was just few days, but I was so crazy on my job hunt. But actually, after having my job, after applying for stuff, I came to know that I can also show my husband's contract.
Understood. So he is already there in the place, so you can't go anywhere.
Or Or if you have a child who's going to a school or going to Kita in the particular state, even you can show that, which means, see, my child is here. He's already in this Kita. We are having no plans of shifting.
Okay.
That is what you, yes, they want proof. They want
proof
of your, or even if at all you have your own house there, that can also be considered as a proof.
Understood. So now this second exam, the KP exam, how mm-hmm. difficult is it? Because that you have to do on mannequins. It is not just like an interview or something. You have to do procedures.
Yes.
So is it very tough? How was your experience?
I wouldn't say it's very tough. Again, I wouldn't say it's very easy. It's like in between. Because, see, again, as I told you, I didn't have a lot of gap between my BDS and my tetanus proofing. It was around 2 to 3 years, and I was in constant touch with dentistry because I was already working after my FSP. So I didn't have a big, like a lag or something like that. And one good thing is I was already in Germany and I was actually a little good at the language also.
Understood.
So that all paved way together for me to actually complete my KP. KP is actually of three different parts. They call Teil in Germany, Teil 1, Teil 2 and Teil 3, means part 1, part 2 and part 3. Part 1 is going to be your schriftlich or written. Then part 2 is going to be your mundlich or your spoken. And part 3 is going to be your
procedures.
Your procedures.
I understand.
This is how it is.
So,
and it's going to be exactly like your final year oral medicine case. Presentation. But one thing is this, what you do on the psychodons is going to be like your endodontics, basically your class 2 cavities, and they'll be asking for what is the plastic pulum's material, so what plastic material do you use to fill
your German is really nice.
Yeah. No, it's been months now. I think I have to kindle again speaking German. Yeah, all these are very important.
Understood. So now, what is the salary range one can expect after FSP and after KP? Is there any variation at that point?
At least what I know, because I'm not someone who's doing their master's. I've not completed my master's yet because I was into maternity leave. So I'm not sure of what the salary range exactly is after or when you or during the course of your master's, because it varies. Okay. So basically, when you are done with your FSP and in a city where you live, okay, so if, for example, you live in a bigger city, you get around 2,500-3,000 euros.
Okay,
again, this is only after FSP.
Understood.
But when you're done with your KP, I think your gross salary is going to be around 5,000-6,000. This is going to be in a city. What I tell you is the
range. Average range. I understood,
yeah,
because that'll vary depending practice to practice, yeah, and how much the doctor
practice
knows,
to practice, yeah. And how much the patients, no? Patient's flow is also very important, and all depends. And what is your, what do you say? What is your capacity? What are the skills you have? What are you able to do in the practice? And what they expect you to do? See, even though you are very good at implantology, for example, and they already have an in-house implantologist, you're not going to be paid for that. So it all depends.
Understood. So once you started working with patients, how was the acceptance out there? Was it easy for you to make the transition to working on patients from India to working on patients in Germany?
No, it was actually not very easy, I should say, because the older patients, no, still they are a little reluctant because they have actually, at least what I know, see, this is totally my personal point of view. I'm not going to generalize this. This is totally my point of view. What I think is still Germans, geriatric population or the older Germans, no, still they are a little reluctant to accept people from outside Germany in general. It's not only Europe, it's outside Germany, because they consider Germans to be the best in whatever they do. I don't know why, but that is how they feel like. Okay, they say, okay, when a German does, he does it properly.
Understood. So there is resistance
that
you have faced.
Kind of resistance is always there. Again, but when there's a lot of expats also coming in, there are a lot of new mothers. There are also people of our age, say around 25 to 35, no? They're a little accepting. They're
understood.
Cool. with that,
So
because they
in
know that anybody who works as a dentist, they'll have to undergo all these procedures, and only if they're really talented, they can just come into it and do. It's not like just go walk into any dentist place and just get a job and continue. No? So I hope they understand things. But anyway, the older Germans are reluctant, still resistant for outsiders like us.
understood. So there's this age gap basically out there.
Yeah, there's always that. That's always there. And sadly, a lot of geriatric cases is what you get on a usual basis when you are in a normal practice.
Okay. So now, if someone wants to follow the path you have taken, any suggestions or mistakes you have done which you think they should not do? Like
Oh my
before
God,
you
I've done a lot
start,
of
know
mistakes.
this. The most important
Again,
ones.
the basic thing is stay focused, which I didn't. Okay, I actually didn't have the. I was actually looking out for a lot of options when I started. No, what if I can do this? What if I can do that? And all. I was just looking for other options also because I wanted to make my path easy. I'm not someone who actually works really hard, puts heart, mind, and soul into it and just go. But I had no other option. Either sit at home or do that. So I was looking for options, but sadly, all my options failed. All what I thought failed. So I had no other option. I just had to do it and I did it. So I would say the first thing anybody who aspires to my position is please be focused. Don't diversify your thoughts. No, like what if I get into pharma industry or something like that? No, never do
Understood.
that. That is the main mistake what I did. And I would say no, never. If you are into this, you are into this. That is what is very important. And second thing, what I would say is keep practicing on your German. Even if it doesn't work out today, it is anyways going to work out in the future because you have limitless or endless times, no, appear for the FSP exam. Only for the KP, it is going to be twice. And for the FSP, it's not going to be like twice or thrice. It is like limitless. You can appear for how many times ever you want. So that is one good thing. So keep practicing your German. It is very, very, very important. Even though you pass your FSP without some, say, good knowledge, or you are very lucky and you just passed it, even though your German is not good. Remember, when you search for a job and you really have a good command of over the language, you can demand for more salary. That
Patient
is very
acceptance will also be
important.
better.
Patient acceptance is also going to be better, and you will also have one self-confidence. Okay, that is very important.
Understood. So now if someone is planning to take the same path and wants to
yeah
contact you from counseling, how can
yeah
they contact you? And where? Should I give you your
counseling from
Instagram page?
counseling. yeah
As in
yeah
if they want to take a path and if you're willing to counsel them or
uh,
advise them.
yeah 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 actually I'm doing this online consultations for people who are really interested and keen into coming to Germany. I think you can give my Instagram link and they'll know the ways of contacting.
Sure, I'll do that. It's very good that you're given us your time, and I'm sure people who are really focused would think about this option and will contact you. Thank you, Dr.
Yeah,
Shruti.
thank you.
Thanks a lot.